Yo, this is Brendan C for the Spear. We're live at Grand Army Plaza. Near the library here. Give me a second. Yeah, there's a Carribbean rally going on for George Floyd. See you at Grand Army Plaza, Brooklyn, New York. You get close in there.
Same shot. Same shot.
Got one more. Got it.
All right, thank you.
I don't see too many Caribbean flags, but, you know. Point of being made. Wondering why the voice is muffled in the morning. Wearing my mask, my bicycle, so. Easy to get to a crowd, you know what I'm saying? So.
Equality across the world. This led to many people focusing on the understanding that Black lives do matter. Even though we know that all lives matter, this being said, we would like to show our support at this time for the Black Lives Matter movement and for our future to come. Let us now bow our heads as we pray and ask God to guide us. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for bringing us here today to come together for the lives that have been lost and for the people people that have gone before us. Lord God, we thank you for the people who are out here to support this movement. We thank you for the people who have come together to make this happen. Lord God, we ask that you would touch each and every individual out here today, even those who are not here, who are fighting for us on the front line at home. But as we come together today, we ask that you bring peace. We ask that you bring justice. We ask that you bring together every person as a unit, as unity. Today, we make history, God, and we ask that you are before us. We ask that you keep everyone safe. Let no harm come our way. Let no diseases touch us. And let us be everything you called us to be. We are royalty under the kingdom of God. And we thank you today. We thank you for every individual. We thank you for everything you are going to do. And we praise your almighty name. Amen.
That was Black Excellence, right? When I say black lives, y'all say matter. Black lives! Black lives! Black lives! Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's with my great pleasure to bring on my brother, my family member. He goes by the name of Corey Caton. He's the leader of the Black Excellence Movement for Black Lives Matter. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a big round of applause for Corey Caton right now.
Thank you, my brother, that child. First of all, can I get a round of applause for God? Can I get a round of applause for God right now, please? If it wasn't for God, none of us would be here right now. I appreciate everybody for coming out. Thank you so much. We are Black Excellence for Black Lives Matter. My name is Corey King, founder of the We Are Black Excellence, Black Lives Matter movement, and purveyor of today's event. I am grateful for the opportunity to bring awareness to the actions surrounding the murder of George Floyd and so many African Americans at the hands of police. I must also admit that I have never felt desire before to be involved in a movement, like this. You know, it has been over 400 years since the arrival of the first Africans on Point Comfort in the state of Virginia in 1619. Over the years, systematic racism has woven its ugly head in every area of the American life, resulting in the barbaric treatment at the hands of those who sworn to protect us, serve us, and that's what's playing out today. So we come as one united body to demand change that our ancestors were able to achieve. Our voices ring loudly today that says business as usual will no longer be tolerated. The awakening of our voices demanding change from east, west, north, south, and in every corner of the world is echoing loud. I am also predicting that these unfortunate events have raised the consciousness of the entire world, and history will recall these times as a defining moment where we as a country and a world accept the fact that racism is real and has infiltrated every aspect of our human lives and must be eradicated. Can we agree? In closing, I want to ask that our efforts today are just the beginning. Guys, this is just the beginning. We have to keep moving forward. We have to keep going. So my charge for you today is very simple. Let us seize the momentum of this opportunity to rid the country of systematic racism, and it starts in the ballot box. We have to vote. Let us collectively ensure that we register every available voter. Thank you. Let us collectively ensure that we register every eligible voter before the deadline and continue our advocacy to the coming election in November. You gotta get your body. When we do, we will accomplish the change we want to see, and our collective voices will have a rippling effect on the future direction of this country, free policy of brutality, racism, and inequality. Guys, one more time. Can everybody hold up their hands or their signs or something? Moment of silence for George Floyd. Moment of silence for everybody who lost their life to police brutality. I want to thank all you guys for coming out here. This right here, is bringing tears to my eyes that so much of us could come out and do something positive in our community. Like, this right here is heartwarming, and I love each and every single one of you guys, man. That comes from the bottom of my heart. I love you all. Thank you for supporting me. Thank you for supporting the movement. Thank you for everybody putting this together. We all look good in black. On the count of three, can I hear everybody sing, "We are Black Excellence"? One, two, three.
We are Black Excellence.
Thank you, guys. Thank you, Reef. I want you to play something that's just going to get people in the mood before we start walking. Right here, this is just the beginning, y'all. Trust me, this is just the beginning.
This song before we get into the speakers. I can't play another song. One more song.
Okay. How's everybody feeling today? How is everybody feeling today? Y'all feeling good? I'm feeling good because I haven't seen a lot of you guys in a long time, and I'm happy to be alive in 2020. But to tell you the truth, I'm a little pissed off. Are you guys pissed off? Matter of fact, I'm a lot pissed off. I'm pissed off because we still telling them the same thing. We still telling them the same thing, and they still don't get it. They still don't get it. Black lives matter. My life matters. Your life matters. My daughter's life matters. Your sons matter. My name is Kevin Crown. A lot of times you see me making everybody feel good, entertaining people. This is not my purpose today. My purpose today is to make you as pissed off as I am. To make you as mad as I am. So we can make everybody as mad as we are. I don't want to do this next year, and the year after that, 5 years after that, 10 years after that. I don't want my kids to have to do this when they are my age. This is why we're doing it now. This year is a special year. And I'm gonna tell y'all something. This is not the time to have no opinion. This is not the time to let somebody else cry your plea. This is not the time for you to sit on TV or social media and watch other people fight your fight. Are you gonna let other people fight your fight? Are you gonna let other people march your march? Thank y'all for coming out. We got some guest speakers here. Now, like I said, this is not the time to be happy. I'm pissed off. I need y'all to be as pissed off as I am. All right? We got another speaker. He's a black business owner. He's of Haitian descent. Shout out to my Zoes. Shout out to all my Caribbean people. Where's my Caribbean people at? So, where's my Haitian brother? Chef Jeff, I need you. Where are you? Where's Chef Jeff? Everybody make some noise. Make some noise. Black excellence, make some noise for Chef Jeff.
I'll be so honest. If you told me a few weeks ago I'd be here right now, I'd call you a liar. It is all right.
I'm a Marine from DR. Marine from DR.
I got the phone call, right? And it was like, there's no yes, there's no wrong. There's no yes, there's no wrong. So they're doing it. I want everybody, when I say I'm black, I want y'all to say as fuck. I'm going to say I'm black, the response is fuck. I'm black. I'm black. I'm also Haitian as fuck, too. Jamaica, we like, all right. So check it out. I work for making patties to protesters. My Instagram page looks like Martin Luther King woke up and just took my shit over. But it's all right, because I'm getting a fucking message out there. I apologize in person. This is coming from the inside and not some bullshit. Oh, facts. So everybody always says, oh, hate king, hate queen. But at the end of the day, we're dead ass kings and queens, though. It's not a hashtag. It's not a fucking term of endearment. We really kings and queens. It wasn't no white motherfuckers that were kings and queens. It was our shit, and they stole it. Furthermore, I want to remind y'all of y'all words. If y'all notice, every time some racist shit comes out, an apology comes out 10 seconds later. Why? Because our fucking money matters. All right? So when y'all go, this shit right here, we cannot stop. Like, we definitely gotta keep it going. And our people, what we do is, we see some walls start coming down, and we stop. Right now, they are nervous. They are shaking to the fucking core. So we gotta keep shit turned up. Another thing, we built this shit for free. If we gotta burn this shit down to get the fucking shit up, burn it down. All right, I'm gonna get back to the PG and stop my emotions from getting to your attention. Get out of here. Cool. I'm gonna end short sweet. Once again, I'm black. I'm black. I love y'all.
Although it is a free country, we are not allowed to curse. Okay, so just be mindful. You didn't know it's okay. All right, check. We are not allies. We are not. We are not allies. Okay? We are. Because we have it. Okay? Trust me.
Yeah, big crowd, I hear what you're saying. But ladies and gentlemen, no justice,
no peace.
No justice,
no peace.
All right, let's move it right along. Ladies and gentlemen, our next speaker for the day goes by the name of Frank McFly from Brooklyn. Frank McFly, talk to them. Let's go.
No justice,
no peace.
No justice,
no peace.
Black lives
matter.
Black lives
matter.
I gotta say that to yourself every day so y'all can remember that. Right now, everybody say, when it's gonna go back to normal? I want a normal again. It's never gonna go back to normal. Normal is not good for us. Make some noise, if normal not good for us. Black lives
matter.
Black lives
matter.
So I'm want y'all to act like it. Everybody's saying to vote, but we gotta start from inside our communities, from borough hall leaders, from senate leaders to community senate leaders. All of that, we gotta start from the beginning before we go all the way up. Black lives
matter.
Black lives
matter.
Tweeting is cool, but we gotta come out here and do what we can, do the most we can. Posting a picture is cool, but we gotta come out here and do what we can. Telling a friend is cool, but we gotta give our money to black businesses. Let me hear you say black businesses.
Black businesses.
Black businesses.
Black businesses.
These big corporations are the ones that bring the systematic racism. So why are we supporting them? Tell me that, why are we supporting them? Fast food is not good for us anyway. Why so hard to quit? No more fast food. Let me say no more fast food.
No more fast food.
Let me say black business only.
Black business only.
Let me say black lives matter.
Black lives matter.
I want y'all to say that every day. Say that to y'all kids. Say that to y'all friends. Say that to y'all family members. Black is God. God is black. We are the creators. We are the kings. I'm going to leave y'all with one last thing. We are not slaves. We were enslaved. We are black kings, black queens. We are God. Black love. Black love. One piss in the air, y'all with me. Let's get it. Y'all ready to go? Come on, y'all got to make more. Y'all know who we at, right? We want everybody over here to hear us. I don't know one person that live in that building. We want them to hear us. Black love. Black love. That's what I'm talking about, y'all. That's what it is. Make some noise, make some noise, make some noise. If you probably your skin complexion, make some noise, put the fist up. Listen to me, Corey K. If you respect Corey K for what he is doing, making this movement, I just need to see the fist up. I need to see the fist up. I have so much stuff to say, but I'm gonna keep it bottled up a little bit because we gotta keep it a little PG-13. But like we said, no justice,
no peace.
Listen to me, we got a couple of chants that I need y'all to know before we go down the road. So this is one of the chants right here, and everybody should know it. If you know it, sing with me right now. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. One. I got one more for y'all. Just listen to what I'm saying and you repeat. Ain't no power like the black people power.
Ain't no power like the black people power.
Cause the black people power won't stop. Everybody say, ain't no power like the black people power, cause the black people power won't
stop.
One more time, ain't no power like the black people power, cause the black people power
won't stop.
I got another speaker to introduce. Her name is Nadia Lopez. Everybody give it up and say Black Lives Matter. Let me hear you say Black Lives Matter. Nadia, where you at? Where you at, Nadia? And this, and let me say this correct. This is Dr. Lopez.
Hello, hello.
Get up there.
I'm just grateful to see everyone out here. But I want you to understand, I opened the school to close a prison. Because I'm very clear that education is the weapon of mass destruction. And when we teach our children who they are, when we teach them that they are revolutionaries, when we teach them that they are kings and queens, they will show up. So I need you to show up. Because the problem is, we're distracted only by one thing. Yes, police brutality is the issue that brought us here. But we are dying in the hospitals from COVID. We are dying from lack of education. One in five children in Brownsville is homeless. After this COVID, after this pandemic, we have 40 million people who don't have jobs. How many more will be without education? They've taken away our funding for next school year for mental health. We are hurting. We are hurting. So I need you to understand, when we talk about black excellence, we are showing up with our ancestors on our backs. Do you understand that? This is for our ancestors. When we talk about black excellence, we are talking about our children, the ones who haven't been even born yet, because the next generation needs us. So I'm asking everyone, black, white, Asian, whoever you are, this is a fight for all of us. because we are tired. They called us slaves. We're not slaves. When they say that we have million-dollar blocks, it's because our bodies are worth $1 million. $80 billion goes to mass incarceration. They can get $2 trillion to save the economy, but you can't save our schools? We're tired of it. So I want everybody here to say, show up.
Show up.
Show up.
Show up.
Show up. And let's get the show on the road.
Can everybody give it up one more time for Doctor? 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 Doctor Oakley. So, you guys ready to march or what?
Yeah! The same chant? We got a different one. All right. All right. So, we got some more chants. If this is your first time doing this, put your hands up. All right.
So we got two more chants I'm gonna teach y'all, right? One is when we get down there by the, like halfway through, we'll let you know when. So, when I say, what do we want? You say justice. What do we want?
Justice!
When I say, when do we want it? You say now. What do we want?
Justice!
When do we want it?
Now!
What do you want?
Justice!
When do we want it?
Now!
That's the first one.
Then I'm gonna say, if we don't get it, shut it down. If we don't get it,
shut it down.
If we don't get it,
shut it down.
If we don't get it,
shut it down.
One more time.
Yeah.
What do we want?
Justice.
When do we want it?
Now.
What do we want?
Justice.
When do we want it?
Now.
If we don't get it,
shut it down.
If we don't get it,
shut it down.
If we don't get it,
shut it down.
So, I just heard that they rerouted us. So, before we march, we gotta find out what's the new route. Wow. Wow. Now, we're going to the Brooklyn Bridge. All right? We're making a left artillery and we're going to the Brooklyn Bridge now. They rerouted us. It's okay. Y'all wanna go home now?
No!
Y'all wanna go home because they told us we gotta go a different way? Tell you a story real quick. I was one of those guys. I was born in Flatbush but raised in Brownsville, Brooklyn. Shout out to anybody who grew up in Brooklyn. I grew up in Brooklyn. All right? I went to high school in Brooklyn, New York City. I party in Brooklyn, New York City. I spend money in Brooklyn, New York City. I was one of those kids that thought stop and frisk was the status quo. I thought I was supposed to get stopped 3 times a week. And they pushed my hands in my pocket. I was those kids that my civil rights got violated 3 times a week until I was 16 years old. I went to high school, I took a test, I went to summer school, and I got to go to a high school outside of my district. And I got to go to school with people who didn't look like me. And when I talked about how I used to get stopped by the police 3 times a week, everybody who looked like me understood. But the people who didn't look like me didn't understand. And I didn't understand why they didn't understand. Then I started putting 2 and 2 together. Then when I was 18 years old, I was performing in a church, doing what God put me on this earth to do. Make people feel good through music. My friend was stopped by the police. He was thrown on his back. He said, Kevin, help me. Get their badge numbers. I thought, hey, I'm not doing nothing wrong. Let me get their badge numbers. So I proceeded to try to get their badge number. They threw me on the ground. They told me they was gonna break my effing arm. They picked me up. They threw me on top of the car, banged my head, I don't know how many times, and threw me in jail. And they said, I tried to take the cuffs off my friend. 7 years. 7 years. I was going to court. I was going to psychiatrists. I was going to all type of things. Every time I got pulled over, I started getting anxiety. Is this going to be my last time?
No.
Is this America? Is this America? Is this America? If this is America, we should not have to go through what I went through when I was 18 years old anymore. Are you guys ready to march?
Yeah.
I can't hear you. You guys ready to march?
Yeah.
Now we're gonna walk with a chant. Kevin and myself are going to teach you the chant. But before we go, remember, guys, they are expecting us to do crazy, dumb shit. Don't do crazy, dumb shit. This is a peaceful protest. We came here for unity. We came here to just prove a point. I don't want nobody here getting locked up. I don't want nobody here not going home to their family. Remember, it's Saturday. You ain't seen a judge till Monday. So you in the buckets for 36 hours. Remember that. They want y'all to fuck up. And Corona's in the jail crazy. So if you go in there without it, you're coming out with it. Peaceful protest. This is coming from Corey K. And again, I want to thank my whole team for putting this together. If it wasn't for them, this would not be possible. Thank the whole, there's too many people to thank, but thank my whole squad, they over here. Everybody, shout out to everybody who purchased a Black Excellence tee. I appreciate the support. Y'all ready to walk? So Kevin, we got one more speaker with him. Yes, yes, the councilwoman. You see y'all, we brought powerful black people here to speak for y'all. Here you go, Queen.
Good afternoon, everyone. Are you blessed? Are you blessed? Are you favored? Because they're saying something else. Are you blessed? Are you favored? Put your arms in the air, hands in the air. Are you blessed? Are you favored? Because they're saying a different narrative out there. So remind them. I was here, standing here, emotional. Every protest I go to, they do not look like me and you. They look like something else. While I'm happy and appreciate the support for people that don't look like me, I need to see people that look like me stand with me. And we need to see this. I'm so, so grateful to see all of you here today. And I want to thank you, Corey, for putting this together. Because this time last year, Black Excellence was hosting an event, and you were all getting your face beat, looking good. But this is a different time in our history. It's a different time in our nation, and it's a different time in New York City. And the Bible advises us to use our time wisely, because we get so distracted by other things. Life throws things at us all the time, and then we're not focused on the right things. And right now, it's about Black lives, yes?
Yes.
If you're not standing out here, all the speakers spoke, so I'm not gonna take too long. If you're not out here with your boots on the ground supporting people like Corey, coming to rallies like this, we will not get legislation passed on City Hall and in the state. I'm telling you right now, Corey said it, a few other people said it today, Dr. Lopez said it, and I'm grateful to see her here. If you do not go out to vote, we will continue to see people like Trump in office. And locally,